For those of you that follow my coffee time videos, this video is going to be quite a bit different than those. As you can tell, lighting is a little bit different because I'm recording this at night versus in the morning. I'm still kind of playing with this whole medium on YouTube, so I'm sure that from time to time I'll release content that is different from the coffee time videos. Additionally, it may seem a bit out of character for me as a pastor to do what I'm going to be doing in this video. But I have waited with real anticipation for Dr. Jordan Peterson to return to the public sphere, especially with all of the chaos that has been going on here in 2020. For those of you that don't know the name Jordan Peterson, a little background might be necessary. Dr. Jordan Peterson is a professor of psychology and a clinical psychologist from Canada. But though that is his profession, in reality, he's spent the better part of the last 4 or 5 years as one of the most prominent public intellectuals. This came after content that he produced on YouTube went viral in about 2015 and 2016, originally having to do with a legal bill that was being passed through the government in Canada. At around the same time, Jordan Peterson released a book called 12 Rules for Life, which became an international bestseller. As the book started to sell and to reach a larger audience, Dr. Peterson began a book tour, which ended up being quite remarkable. A lot of book tours result in a few stops with a moderate crowd. But Dr. Peterson's talks on 12 Rules for Life continued for nearly a year at maybe 100 different theaters, mostly in the US, but ultimately throughout Western Europe, Canada, Australia, and elsewhere. Every venue that he went and spoke at was packed. He came to San Diego, where I live, twice, and I attended both talks. The first time I went alone, and the second time I brought my wife and my parents. I have truly been amazed by the rise of Jordan Peterson. I've written on his message and his influence a couple of times. Both of those articles were published by one of the groups that I and our church are affiliated with, Calvary Chapel. And they can be found on my website at pastormiles.com/Jordan Peterson. As Dr. Peterson's book tour was coming to an end, his wife was diagnosed with cancer. And with the stress he was experiencing due to a constant media barrage because of his writing and the things that he was talking about, and his wife's cancer, he began taking benzodiazepines for anxiety. And as has been related to his fans from his daughter, Michaela, Dr. Peterson had what is called a paradoxical reaction to the medication that he was taking. That resulted in some horrible effects over the last year. And it seems that on several occasions in the last year, his treatment nearly brought him to the point where he lost his life. All of this is a bit of a long preface introduction, but I recognize that you may not know who Dr. Peterson is, so this might be necessary. On Monday, October 19th, today, as I'm recording this, Dr. Peterson released a video on his YouTube channel entitled Return Home. Being that I am subscribed to his channel, I was notified as soon as the video was released, and I watched it soon after it was released. This video is effectively a response to that video, my thoughts, if you will. Again, it may seem a little bit odd that I would record a video like this, so let me give you just a little bit of an explanation as to why I'm even posting this. Yes, I am a fan of Dr. Peterson. I've read 12 Rules for Life a couple of times, and I've listened to dozens and dozens of hours of his podcast audio, and I've watched a lot of his content online. I think that Jordan Peterson has important things to say in the cultural moment we find ourselves in here in the West. A lot of the things that he has warned about in his lectures have almost seemed prophetic. If you listen to what he and others within his circle, which has sometimes been referred to as the intellectual dark web, if you listen to what they have been saying, you know that many of the warnings that they have given have come to pass, especially in 2020. And as these things have come to pass this year, Jordan Peterson's voice has been notably absent in everything that's been going on. I'm not sure that his voice speaking into the happenings of 2020 would really affect or change anything, but chaotic times such as these seem to require clarion and prophetic voices to provide context and clarity. So I am hopeful, as are probably many others, that Dr. Peterson will be able to recover and speak once again. That at this moment remains to be seen. The video he released on Monday today shows a man that is not 100%. He is still on the mend, if you will. He looks pretty frail. And in a very interesting way, he looks exactly as you would expect him to look if this were a three-act play. In his lectures, Dr. Peterson speaks often of archetypes, as in Jungian archetypes. And he mentions frequently the hero's journey. And as we are seeing it, the hero in this situation, Jordan Peterson, has returned after the second act in which the hero has been struck to the point of nearly being overcome. And we are now, in essence, at the return of the Jedi moment. He's been humbled and hobbled by all that he's gone through, and now, seemingly at just the right time, he's kind of emerged. He still has a mission that it remains to be seen whether or not he'll be able to accomplish it. When I first began following Peterson in 2016, he was relatively unknown. He was mostly a secular research professor, but he was delivering biblical lectures on the book of Genesis. Now, I'm a pastor. These are the things that are far more associated with my profession than his, and yet he was attracting, with his biblical lectures, the very demographic of North America and Western European society that the church has largely failed to reach in the last probably quarter century or more. He was reaching men, guys, ages like 20 to 45. And to me at the time when I saw this, this was striking. His biblical commentary was anything but orthodox, and there were pretty large gaps in his theological and biblical understanding, but they were still fascinating talks. And as a result of his lectures, individuals, predominantly men in that aforementioned demographic, were getting things sorted out in their lives and putting their lives together, which is absolutely a net positive. Since my late teens, I've worked to order my life in such a way that would hopefully produce the best outcomes according to what might be termed as ancient wisdom. I think it's partly why I was attracted to Dr. Peterson in the first place. His exhortations in his lectures and writings are drawn from the same well, so I find a lot of crossover in his teaching and mine. All genuine truth originates from the same place, what you might refer to as the Logos. I think that it is good that Dr. Peterson has once again stepped onto the stage, and I and many other Christians have been praying for him over the last year. Jordan Peterson is not a Christian in the traditional Protestant sense, but he lectures, or perhaps I should say he preaches, from the biblical stories. And he has said, when asked whether or not he believes in God, that I act as though God exists. And I think that that's a pretty good place to start. It's not the end point, but it's a good place to start. His belief and his preaching has motivated many to re-engage, or maybe even engage for the first time, with the narrative of Scripture, and that's a good thing. In the last couple of years, I've met a number of young men that began to probe the teachings of Scripture because of Dr. Jordan Peterson. He is an unlikely evangelist for the Christian worldview, or maybe rather, at the very least, for a Judeo-Christian worldview, which he seems to believe leads to the betterment of societies. Obviously, I would agree with that, much more so than the alternatives that are out there, a view that the postmodern neo-Marxist West now repudiates. So we're in the third act, and it will be fascinating to see how this story wraps up. Welcome back, Jordan Peterson. Pray that you and your family are well.